In this video, I'm gonna show you how to increase or improve your FPS in Apex Legends or how to get more FPS in Apex. In this tutorial, we're gonna tweak the in-game settings, some origin settings, and we're gonna optimize your PC for gaming, so make sure that you watch this video till the end and don't skip any steps. And let's start. So first of all, what you want to do is simply click on the link in the description and download the Apex Legends FPS boost pack and unzip it. You can use WinRAR or WinZip. Once you unzip it, you should have this folder on your desktop. Inside, there is a configs folder, optimizations folder, launch options notepad file, and ultimate performance mode notepad file. The first step is to open up Origin, click on My Game Library, and now right-click on Apex Legends. Click on Game Properties. And now click on Enable Origin In-Game for Apex Legends. So you want to uncheck that. Once you uncheck it, click on the Advanced Launch Options tab. And now open the FPS Boost Pack. Open the Launch Options Notepad file. And now copy the first line of the text document. Once you copy it, just go ahead and paste it in the command line arguments box. Now what you want to do is change the refresh rate to the refresh rate of your monitor. So if you have a 60Hz monitor, then what you want to do is type 60. If you have a 144Hz monitor, then just type 144. Mine is 120Hz, so I'm gonna type 120. Once you're done, what you want to do is simply click on Save, and now click on Origin in the top left corner. Click on Application Settings. Click on More, and click on Origin In-Game. Click on Disable Origin, so this should be unchecked. And once you do that, you can now close the Origin Launcher and close the Notepad file. Okay. The second step in this video is to change the in-game settings. You can do that by opening Apex Legends and click on the settings icon. Click on settings, and now what you want to do is click on the video tab. Okay. What you want to do first is set the display mode to full screen. Set the aspect ratio to native. Set the resolution to native as well. You can play around with the brightness and set it however you'd like, and you can also play around with the field of view. Now what you want to do is disable the VSync, so disable it, set the anti-aliasing to off, set the texture streaming budget to 3 or 4, so I'm gonna set it to medium, 3GB VRAM, set the texture filtering to bilinear. Set the ambient occlusion to disabled. Set the sun shadow coverage to low. Set the sun shadow detail to low. Set the spot shadow detail to low or disabled. Set the volumetric lighting to disabled. Set dynamic spot shadows to disabled as well. Set the modal detail to low. Effect detail to low. Impact marks to disabled. And ragdolls to low. Once you're done, click on Apply, click on the Escape button or click on Back, and you can now close Apex Legends and move to the next steps. And now once you're done with the in-game settings, we're gonna optimize your PC for gaming. So first of all, what you want to do is open up This PC, and you can do that by clicking on the search bar and type This PC, and click on it. Now open Local Disk C, or whatever drive you have Apex Legends installed on, so mine is at C. Now click on Users and open it up. Open up your user, so PC for me. Scroll down and open the Saved Games folder. Now open the Respawn folder. Open the Apex folder. Open the Local folder. And now what you want to do is open the FPS boost pack, click on the configs folder, And now choose whether you want the high-end or low-end settings. I would recommend going with the low-end settings, it will just give you more FPS. Open up the low-end or high-end folder. And now copy the video config text document here. So just right-click on it, click on copy, and now paste it in the Apex local folder. Right-click on it, paste, and click on replace the file in the destination. Once you replace it, right-click on video config, click on properties, and make sure that the read-only box is checked. Now click on OK, and you can now close the folder. After you paste the notepad file, don't change any in-game settings in Apex Legends, or this will just revert the changes that you've just made. The next step is to open up this PC again. And once you open it up, what you want to do is open local disk C, open the program files x86 folder, and now open the origin games folder. Now open the Apex folder, and open the CFG folder. Now go back to the FPS boost pack, and copy the AuraExec CFG file, and paste it in the CFG folder. Okay. Now what you want to do is just close the CFG folder and move on to the next step. The next step is to right click on Apex Legends, click on open file location, and right click on R5 Apex, click on properties, go to the compatibility tab and check the disable full screen optimizations box. Now click on change high DPI settings and check the override high DPI scaling behavior scaling performed by box. It should be application. Once you're done, click on OK, click on apply and click on OK again. You can now close this folder. The next step is to open up the FPS boost pack, go back, and open the optimizations folder. Now open the Apex priority folder, and double click on Apex high priority. Click on yes, it says are you sure you want to continue, click on yes again, and click on OK. If this causes your game to crash, then what you want to do is just go back to this folder and double click on Apex Normal Priority. The next step is to click on the search bar and type REG Edit and open the registry editor. Click on yes, and now what you want to do is click on the arrow next to current user, click on the arrow next to system, click on the arrow next to game config store. Now click on the arrow next to children and right click on children. Click on find and now type R5 Apex and click on find next. And as you can see, this folder is highlighted. What you want to do is just right click on it and click on delete. It says are you sure you want to permanently delete this key and all of its subkeys? Click on yes. And you can now close the registry editor. The next step is to open the FPS boost pack, go back, and open the ultimate performance mode notepad file. Now click on the search bar and type CMD, right click on the command prompt and click on run as administrator. Click on yes. Now copy the command from the ultimate performance mode notepad file and paste it in CMD, click on enter, and as you can see the ultimate performance is enabled. You can now close the command prompt, and now click on the search bar and type edit, power plan, and open it. Click on the power options, and now click on the box where it says ultimate performance. Once you check it, you can now close the power options and ultimate performance is enabled. You can now close the notepad file. The next step is to open the FPS boost pack and open the optimizations folder. Now double click on quick CPU setup, click on next, accept the terms and click on next again, next, install. Click on yes and wait for it to finish. Once you're done, click on finish, click on yes, and it should open up. Now make sure that the system power plan is set to ultimate performance. Make sure that the core parking index is 100%. So if it's not, what you want to do is just get it to 100%. Make sure that the frequency scaling index is at 100%. And make sure that the turbo boost index is at 100% as well. Once you're done, click on apply. It should say changes successfully applied. Click on OK and you can now close the quick CPU setup. The next step is to double click on NVIDIA Profile Inspector. Click on yes. And now click on where it says profiles and type Apex Legends and click on it. Okay, now what you want to do is set the frame rate limiter mode to frame rate limiter delay flip by flip metering. So just click on it and click on apply changes. Once you're done, you can now close the NVIDIA Profile Inspector app. The next step is to open the ISLC folder, double click on Intelligent Standby List Cleaner, click on yes, and now once you open it, click on this arrow and you should see the icon in here. What you want to do is just double click on it and it should open up. Okay, click on stop if it's already working and make sure that the enable custom timer resolution box is checked. Once you check it, type 0.5 in the wanted timer resolution and type 1024 megabytes in the list size is at least box and then type 8196 megabytes in the free memory is lower than if you have 16 gigabytes of RAM. If you have 8 gigabytes of RAM, then type 4096 and if you have 32 gigabytes of RAM, type 16000. Once you're done, click on purge standby list and click on start. And you can now minimize it. Once you're done, click on the back button and open the GPU settings. Once you open the GPU settings folder, what you want to do is right click on your desktop and click on NVIDIA control panel. Now open the first image and make sure that you copy all of the commands. So what you want to do is click on manage 3D settings. Make sure that the preferred graphics processor is set as high performance NVIDIA processor. And now just copy all of the settings from this image. And once you're done, open up the second image and copy the rest of the commands. Once you're done, click on apply. Wait for the settings to be applied and you can then close the NVIDIA control panel. You can now close the Apex Legends FPS boost pack and click on the search bar and type regedit again and open the registry editor. Click on yes and now click on HK local machine, so click on the arrow next to it. Click on the arrow next to software. Now click on the arrow next to Microsoft. Click on the arrow next to Windows NT. Click on the arrow next to current version. Now click on the arrow next to multimedia. Click on system profile. So click on the system profile folder. And now double click on system responsiveness. And set it to 1. So type 1 in the value data box. Once you type it, click on OK. And now click on the arrow next to system profile. Click on the arrow next to tasks. Click on the games folder. And now set the GPU priority to 8. So type 8 in the value data box and click on OK. Set the priority to 6, so type 6 in the value data box and click on OK. Open scheduling category and type high, click on OK, and then open up SFIO priority, type high as well, and once you're done, click on OK. So just a reminder, what you want to do is type 8 in the GPU priority, 6 in priority, high in scheduling category, and high in SFIO priority. Once you're done, you can now close the registry editor and restart your PC for the settings to be applied. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to my channel and like this video if it helped. Bye.